They lucky this ain't 2K11, 2K12, 2K13. Real talk. It's when I was in my prime, feeling like Jordan, Bron James, Kobe Bryant. Yeah, taking boys' lunch money, $100 a game, $200 a game. Feeling like Debo. But now it's 10 years later. Now I'm feeling like Vince Carter with the Hawks. Feeling like Dirk Nowitzki with Luka Doncic. Hell, I'm feeling like Dwight right now. 13 minutes, 5 points, 2 rebounds. But you know what? It's all good. We gonna turn this into Michael Jordan with the Wizards. Real talk. We about to get a few buckets. We about to do our thing a little bit. We gonna watch this film. We gonna make them adjustments. Everybody got me fucked up.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy Incredible, and I'm coming at you with another video. Hey, listen. So guys, last week, I played 3 of the top guys in the community within a span of 5 days, guys. I'm still trying to figure out, 2K, what do you have against me? What are you doing, bro? But you know what? It may be a blessing in disguise because I've had the chance to have my experience against some of the top players, and I got the opportunity to break down some film and learn some things from what I saw and felt throughout those games, guys. So that's what we'll be doing today, man. Let's get right into it. First things first, these guys are professional 2K players, man. They put in double, maybe triple, the amount of hours than the average 2K player. But they have a bigger goal in mind, and that is $200,000. Plus tax, of course. But nonetheless, $200,000. These guys are making sure all the holes are covered in their game, man. But, hey, man, let's see what they got to offer, man. So the first thing you will notice about a comp player is full court press, or just pressure in general. They are trying to make you speed up your gameplay, guys, and it is very effective because for the average player, they're not used to playing this fast, they're not used to getting sped up, and it usually leads to turnovers, which equates to points, which equates to blowouts, man. But me personally, against Ty Debo and Splash, I felt that I was doing a good job kind of slowing down. So I didn't really throw too many turnovers against those guys. But against Isaac, I didn't know I was playing him as he was on another account. And I was just out there willy-nilly. But yes, guys, this full court pressure is the real deal, man. Now, of course, full court pressure leads into what these guys specialize in, and that is playing the passing lanes, guys. These guys are masterful with the passing lane, being in the perfect position, knowing exactly where you want to throw your next pass, also baiting you into throwing a pass and then being there as soon as you pass it. These guys are really great at that, man. These guys will even be patient, and they are always making sure they're clicking on the right guys that looks like they're open and making that play. So pressure and passing lanes are these guys' bread and butter, creating fast turnovers. But let's talk about half-court defense, because these guys are really good at that as well, man. These guys are gonna force you to play a little faster, so it's gonna kind of make you a little hesitant, you know, when they start gambling on defense like that right there. But they're pretty sound. and they know the rotations they need to make. Plus, they also understand the game, when corners will drop, how they got their settings set as far as switching and what moves need to be made. So, yeah, man. Along with pressure, passing lanes, they don't get none of those, they will be getting the stop. Now, I'm not the best offensive player, but if you got a couple moves that gets you open or that can get you to the cup, get you easy shots, that will work. And also, if you're running sets, plays to get you open, that will work as well. But for the most part, these guys are good on half court defense as well. Shifting over from defense, where at the very least, a comp player will be able to bait and pass intercept you guys. We are switching over to offense, man, where comp players, they will have some moves in their bag. Now, like I said, you have offensive comp players, you got defensive comp players, but they have moves that, you know, go to moves that they will, you know, can depend on when they need a bucket. You even got some comp guys that will run plays, and that's very effective, especially in NBA 2K22. So, yeah, man, comp guys are really good on offense as well, man. These guys are definitely, you can tell that these guys have put their hours in to make sure that they have ways to score when the defense is tough, or, you know, if they just need a quick bucket. Okay, so one of the last things I will point out that these guys do very well, and it's very big in the comp community, is being able to green. And these guys do that very well. If they're open, they're pretty much going to green. And that takes a lot of hours in the gym to, you know, each shot. Being able to pull up and green, coming off of moves and green, you know, even contested greens, on the move greens. So, yeah, man, these guys are very big on that. And apparently, if you don't green, you trash. So, yes, man, these guys have all that down pat, man. So, there it is, guys. There it is. So those are pretty much the main things that these guys specialize in, guys. But for the most part, these guys know 2K. They know movements. They know human tendencies, which is very important. They know computer tendencies. They know how 2K works. And they definitely take advantage of that, man. So, yeah, guys. Shout out to all the comp guys, not just these three. These are three of the top comp guys for the last few years, but there are plenty more. And this year, guys, I think it will be a little tougher as 2K22 is very different from all the rest of the 2Ks. So I expect to see these guys in the 250K tournament. And yeah, man, that'll do it. That'll do it. All right, guys, after breaking down the film, you guys see exactly why these guys are top of the line comp players, man. These guys are literally technicians and specialists in the game of 2K. So props to those guys. Just for a little context, I played Splash in the 250K tournament qualifiers, and I was just looking for a few matches for some competition. And yeah, I got more than what I was looking for. End up quitting early because I had some things to do. I would have stayed in the game longer with Splash if I didn't have a couple things to do, but he was already running away with it. And yeah, I needed to go ahead and call it, man. So later on in the week, I met up with Isaac, not knowingly, as he was playing on somebody else's account. I was going up the pink diamond tier, and yeah, man, I wasn't expecting anybody to be that good that I played. So I was just going in there willy-nilly, doing what I could do, as I had just gotten a couple wins and I was feeling good about myself. But obviously, yeah, that was the end of that. But still eventually reached the Galaxy Opal tier. within the next day, where I matched up with Ty Debo. And let's just say I did not get whipped, guys, you know. But it's okay because I did learn some things today. And moving forward, you know, I'll be able to play the game a little bit more. So I will be at least a little bit better, guys. But enough of that, guys. The question you have all been waiting for, guys. Who do I think will win the 250K tournament, guys? There's literally only one answer, man. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Who do I think will win the 250K tournament? I have no fucking clue.